You know, Traeger, three's a crowd. Now, cutting the Hornet in it is asking for trouble.
Would you rather have him come out here looking for it?
Come in.
Hold it.
Now, what's all that for?
I don't like being frisked. Either we trust each other, or you can count me out.
You understand now, Steve, why we need him?
Okay, okay. But if we're going to talk business, he's all we need.
Okay, guys, out.
If you have any doubts about me, Gant, let's hear about them now.
Oh, he just doesn't like the idea of cutting up the take three ways, that's all.
Maybe he'd like it better if we cut up each other.
Now, here's the map, gentlemen. I've circled the areas where...
Mr. Traeger.
What is it, Jess?
Got this creep nosing around outside.
Who is he?
It's Mike Axford. He's a reporter for the Sentinel. I'll take care of him.
Oh, this is my party, remember?
Now, hold it, hold it. This guy ain't no ordinary sloop. It's got to be done right.
Meaning it wouldn't be?
If we're going to work together, let's start right now. High card decides, all right?
All right with me.
Fine.
Head.
King. That ought to do it.
Ace. Sorry, Traeger. Axford's all mine.
What are you trying to do?
Taking care of Axford was my job, remember? He's dead. Take him to the car. I think we've done enough business for tonight.
All right. Tomorrow, then. Same time, same place.
All right with you?
Same time, same place.
Another challenge for the Green Hornet. His aide, Cato, and their rolling arsenal, the Black Beauty. On police records, a wanted criminal, the Green Hornet is really Britt Reed, owner publisher of the Daily Sentinel. His dual identity known only to his secretary and to the district attorney. And now, to protect the rights and lives of decent citizens, rides the Green Hornet.
just can't be.
It looks as if it can.
He's bound and determined to follow that lead on Traeger. I begged him to check with you first.
He wouldn't listen to me either.
Poor Mike. I hope whoever did it gets what he deserves.
Yeah, I hope so, too.
What do you mean? You say right here in your article, as publisher of the Daily Sentinel, I have in my possession a signed affidavit, signed by one of the conspirators, naming the man responsible for Axford's probable murder.
As soon as this statement can be verified by the Sentinel staff, it will be turned over to the district attorney, Frank Scanlon. Why wait? Let me see it now.
There is no affidavit.
Again, we have nothing on Traeger.
But we do. Show him, Cato. Come here, Frank. Why, that's Axford.
That's right.
But the paper said he was dead.
That's for Traeger's benefit and Steve Gant.
Well, where does Gant fit in?
Mike blundered into a top secret meeting. The big boys were forming an alliance. They invited the Green Hornet to join.
You were there?
Luckily for Mike, we were.
Hey, that's quite a combination. Traeger and Gant, huh? They've been at each other's throats for years.
They're after you now, Frank. If they join forces, they can control this town.
Yeah, what's going to stop them?
Mike Axford.
Axford? How?
Gant and Traeger both believe that he's dead, and it's exactly what I want them to believe. The right moment, I'm going to use him as bait.
What kind of bait? How?
To create suspicion and doubt about each other.
Where have you got him?
That room is in the basement. I have cameras all over the house. There's one of them up there. Closed-circuit television. Sort of a built-in burglar alarm.
Well, isn't that risky? Mike might realize where he is.
No. He thinks he's a prisoner of the Green Hornet.
How long do you want to keep him here?
If my plan works, he'll be free tonight.
Don't worry, I'll get you the Traegers on time.
We ought to be there now.
Very long.
That's almost long enough.
If we hurry.
I should have known it.
Gant's been waiting for a chance to get me, and I have to hand it to him on a silver platter.
Aren't you jumping to conclusions, Traeger?
Am I? Well, where's Gant? Can you think of one good reason why he isn't here at this meeting?
No.
Well, neither can I, but I can think of some bad reasons. Like him helping Britt Reed verify that affidavit.
Then we better go to work.
No. As long as Axford stays missing, you've done your job. Taking care of Gant will be my pleasure.
Anything you say, Mr. Traeger.
Trying to get us killed?
No, but Traeger's planning on it.
Why?
Haven't you read the papers? He thinks you gave Reed the affidavit.
Why me? There was three of us in the room, including you.
He's got some sort of information, and you're the one that he's after.
I knew I should never deal with him. Well, thanks for the warning.
I hate to see a good thing go down the drain. We could have had this town in our hip pocket.
Now it's done before it's begun, huh?
It doesn't have to be.
Meaning?
If you're clean, then Reed has all the answers. The affidavit, for instance.
You think he'd give it to me?
No. But what's to prevent you from taking it? A little persuasion? Your boy here seems to be an expert at that.
Yeah, how about that, Nixie? You think we can get away with it, huh?
We can try.
Wish you luck.
Yeah.
Let's go. We don't want to keep them waiting.
He's the squealer.
What do you suppose he is?
Somewhere's in this house, probably. We gotta get Traeger out here. Let him see for himself. I ain't the one double-crossing him. It's the Hornet.
Yeah. All right, Cato, they've seen enough. When the phone rings, answer it. Make sure they hear you.
All right.
He's fine. No, nothing so far. But there's a strange car parked across the street.
Yes, sir, I'll get the license number just in case.
That did it, Cato. They're on their way. Meet me at the car.
Office?
Miss Case, I don't have any time for questions. Just listen, please. Mike is all right. He's hot, red hot. That's why we had to keep you in the dark. Do you understand?
No, I don't understand. But don't let that bother you any.
We're leaving him off at his place. He probably won't come to for hours, but if he calls in, tell him to stay put. We don't want anyone to know that he's alive. All right?
Yes, I got the message. Shall I repeat it? Thanks a lot.
What did she say?
She's furious that we didn't tell her the truth about Mike.
She's furious? Wait till Traeger finds out.
And that's the way it was. Ain't that right, Dixie?
That's right. Are you sure it was the reporter?
What's the matter with you? You think I'd be stupid enough to lie? The Hornet knocked your gun, remember? That chauffeur was faking when he said the guy was dead.
Then why did the Hornet turn him over to Reed?
Well, so he could split us up.
Isn't that what you're trying to do, Gant? Let's talk first. You can always shoot later.
There's been enough talk already.
Maybe Traeger would like to hear the truth for a change.
I'd like to hear what you did with Axford.
If I could trust your friend, Mr. Gant, I'd tell you exactly. Under the circumstances, all I'll say is I hid the body where nobody'll find it.
Oh, you ain't gonna believe that, are you?
It's a lot better than your story. Or do you believe in ghosts, too?
I don't know.
I'm telling you, I saw that Axford guy alive.
Where?
At Reed's.
Well, then let's go to Reed's. I'd like to see Axford for myself.
Yeah, let's do that.
Mr. Reed's office? Mike, how are you?
Look, Casey, you've got to believe me. I'm cold sober. And I'm home. I don't know how the devil I got here or what day it is. Let me speak to the boss.
Well, he's not in. I don't know how to reach him. But he left strict orders for you to stay put.
What are you talking about? I've got a story that can't wait.
It'll have to wait, Mike. You step out of your apartment and you could be dead.
How did you know? I was so mixed up, I thought it was just a dream. But I got a peach of a headache that says it wasn't.
You go back to bed, Mike, please. You can talk to Mr. Reed in the morning.
But Casey,
there's nobody upstairs either.
Well, Gant, Axford doesn't seem to be anywhere in the house.
He's gotta be. There, the TV. It showed him in a room somewheres.
Well, in that case, he's still gotta be there. Let's see.
That's very funny. Why aren't you laughing?
I ran out of smokes. Can you...
Hey, Mike. You're alive? You're not dead?
Do I look that bad? Come on, Gus. Stop acting like I'm a ghost.
Mike, don't you read your own paper?
What are you talking about?
Well, look right here on page one.
Gus, I just asked you... Missing. Feared dead. What kind of story is this?
Hey, Mike, what about the smokes?
There's a locked room down in the basement. That must be where they're hiding him.
Yeah.
Show us.
Here it is. Open it.
Excuse me, please. Let me.
Steve, but not good enough.
Now listen, Traeger. Why should I sing to Reed, huh? If I wanted out in this deal, I'd have gotten out.
You are out. Way out. Take him upstairs.
Get him.
Upstairs.
Let's go. Thinking what I am?
What is it?
That affidavit's in there.
I'd sure like to get my hands on it.
There's one way to find out. Stand back.
Hey, here it is.
Who signed it? Boy, this is ridiculous.
Well, who signed it?
Oh, you two-bit squealer. You signed it!
Would I frame myself? Would I confess to killing Axford?
How do I know who you framed? It could have been me or the Hornet.
Why would I want to frame anybody? It was my idea to include all of you in on the deal. I was ready to throw in my rackets on the deal also.
This sounds like a double cross, pure and simple. And I ain't gonna stand still for it.
You haven't got any choice. You're just gonna take it.
Shall we join them?
Not yet.
Hold it. Axford.
He ain't dead.
No, he's only knocked out.
There it is, Traeger. The double cross. And it ain't you, and it ain't me.
They'll sleep for a while. I gave them all a dose of Hornet gas. Yes, Mike got notes on the whole thing. You'll have more than enough to make the charges stick. Mike? Well, he got into a little more trouble, but he'll be all right. In fact, we're taking him home right now and putting him back to bed.
See me as soon as I came in.
We're worried about you, Mike. We called your apartment.
Yeah, I slept late. I thought I did. Then I went out to get some coffee to try to wake up so I could straighten out the story. But even after six cups...
Here, maybe this will straighten you out.
Oh, no. Do I have to read the paper to find out what I'm doing?
We're very proud of you, Mike.
Why? I didn't write a line.
Look, Mike, it's easy to hire a man to write the news. But you're the kind that makes it.
Thanks. But if it's all the same to you, boss, I'll stick to bylines. Headlines are too big a headache.